We have a very exciting myth today from an unbelievably special viewer.
Who's that?
None other than James Cameron. Hey, James. Could you tell Jamie what you told me?
Sure. So for the last few months since I released Titanic in 3D, I've been getting dozens of emails every day saying that Rose is a selfish so-and-so and Jack's an idiot.
Who are Rose and Jack?
Two main characters of the movie.
The movie, the second highest grossing of all time, was anything but a disaster. But the ending has caused a storm of protest. Desperate to survive in the freezing cold North Atlantic,
Stay on, Rose.
Jack and Rose attempt to clamber onto a piece of debris. And seemingly, there's room aboard for just one. And Jack, being the noble hero he is, sacrifices himself to keep Rose's head above water. But multitudes of Titanic and Mythbuster fans don't believe it. James Cameron's inbox has been flooded with the theory that both hero and heroine could have lived to tell their Titanic tale.
Okay, so I need you guys to find out who's right, these so-called fans or my movie.
Okay, it seems to me the place we start is with buoyancy. The question is, could the board possibly have supported both Rose and Jack?
I agree, but the second issue is about survival in those freezing conditions.
You mean if they both could have died regardless of the board?
Exactly.
Well, let's say I get started doing some small-scale testing with the mini board and a mini Rose and Jack.
And why don't I start to prep for some hypothermia tests?
And I'll get back to sweeping up.
Awesome.
So the epic full-scale Jack and Rose reenactment comes later.
Let's see if we can both get on this thing.
Because this Titanic tale won't set sail until it's been tested in safer waters, where the guys opt for an efficient division of labor. Jamie's taking charge of how to quantify and replicate the hero's hypothermia and grumble about the lack of logic in love. While Adam's cutting things down to size.
Okay, the myth in miniature. So what are you gonna do?
I'm glad you asked. I'm gonna start by playing with dolls. I'm gonna make some very accurate dolls of Rose and Jack, accurate both in terms of their size, but also in their weight. And then I'm gonna put them on a piece of wood that is exactly the same type of wood as the original.
Right, so white oak.
Yes, and basically put that in a tub full of salty water and see what happens.
And prove my movie was right.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe.
There we go. Rose lies down on it. Oh. Oh, that actually, wow. In the movie, you can see that it's lapping on most of the board, and that's exactly what we're getting here.
So far, so good. Adam's eye for detailed and mathematically accurate scaling has paid off. Now, what about the myth itself? Could Jack have jumped aboard?
Here we go. Jack and Rose. Nope. Whoa, whoa, whoa. They're about sinking. Hold on. It doesn't look like they can stay afloat.
That means this maiden voyage myth is on thin ice, and the movie's looking like the real deal.
Science is on my side.
Now, of course, Jamie and I are going to experiment with this in full scale.
Yep, it's too early to call it yet.
There they go.
No.
Because the problem is not just about buoyancy. To find out if the film failed in the survivability stakes, Adam and Jamie will examine every aspect of cold water endurance.
It's alive!
Enter Thermoman.
There it goes.
Oh! Adam and Jamie, cyborg midwives.